Welcome to All the Things, a podcast for moms seeking an inspired life. Hi, I'm Lisa Chin. I am a writer, a coach, a mom, a daughter, a sister, and many, many, many other things. And I am also the host and creator of this podcast. Now, before I get started, I wanted to first acknowledge that I am speaking from the traditional and unceded lands of the Nipmuc and Massachusetts tribes. The examination of who we are, which is ultimately the intention of this podcast, would really not be complete without acknowledging those people who took care of and stewarded this land that I live, work, and create from. And while the conversations in this podcast will be mostly aspirational and topics as well, it's important to ground ourselves each and every time that we live, work, and create in social and cultural systems of inequities and injustices. Now, what am I talking about when I say moms who seek an inspired life? Because ultimately, you're probably thinking, am I in the right place? So when I say moms, I mean anyone who mothers, and you can mother your biological children, you can mother your adopted children, you can mother children you have birthed via a surrogate. The terminology is not as important as the energy of someone who's nurturing and caring and building and creating something. And I like to say mothers because I am one. I believe that the experience of being a mom is so bizarre in our modern day culture. But I also think that that perspective of motherhood is actually really important for anyone on this self-identity journey. In understanding who we are, we all came from a uterus, right? And whether or not we lived with our mothers or lived with a mother when we grow up or have a relationship now, all of that plays a role into who we are. So when I speak about motherhood in this podcast, the angles that it can be interpreted in is actually from the standpoint of a mother, as well as a daughter, as well as a grandmother, and anyone really, and even a son if you identify as male. So I just, ever since becoming a mom, I have felt so strongly about how conversations really need to happen, and I see moms as such powerhouses that are kind of ignored in our culture. And a lot of like self-doubt because of the shaming and blaming that's placed on moms. And it's important that we kind of bring light to that and that we work through that together, because the whole reason motherhood isn't working right now is because we're trying to do it alone. Now, moving on to an inspired life, how do you know you're in the right place? If you're seeking an inspired life, you're in the right place. An inspired life is one where you are creating and you are following those curiosities and inspirations that are calling to you, that are tugging at your soul, that are asking to have a place in this world. And ultimately, you're doing good in the world. And I don't care if doing good means you're picking up a piece of trash off the ground or if you are leading a march. All of it is doing good. There's no, you know, they say there's no like trauma Olympics. There's no doing good Olympics, right? You're either doing good or you're not, is how I see it. And when you're not, you know, chances are it's just because you're having not so great day, not because you're a bad person or you're not worthy or you're not impactful or anything like that. I found that seeking curiosities and inspirations is so fulfilling and so important, especially when I became a mother. And an inspired life, I want to say, is in great contrast to an inspiring life. And for a very long time, I had been pursuing an inspiring life where I was trying to bring inspiration to others. That was almost my intention, more so than to bring inspiration to myself. And that is really a true difference. So it's like if you're posting on social media for the likes, or if you're just posting on social media to self-express. And always kind of understanding that we do all have an ego and we're all working on that and trying to keep it in check and all of that. But in that inspired life, we are really working towards kind of that inner self, that true self within us. This podcast will circulate through a lot of different topics. The first season will be people that I know, and then I have a number of other topics kind of scheduled following that. I believe that the examination of self cannot be achieved through just really one angle. And I think that a lot of people do a fantastic job of honing in on a very specific strategy or technique or lens. And I hope to bring a lot of those people onto this podcast. But for me, I've always been about all the things. Even growing up, I kind of dabbled in a little bit of everything because I don't believe there's one solution for everyone. I think there's many, many different solutions. And I also think that the beauty is the overlap of all those solutions when we bring it into our kind of force field, if you will. So I'm just really excited for this podcast. It is a long time coming. I am so grateful for the friends and family that have supported me in bringing this to fruition. And I'm really excited to share with you. And I'm really excited to meet you and hear your thoughts about what you'd like to talk about and what you'd like to see and what the significance of an inspired life is for you. If you'd like to learn more about me, I am at lisaforreal.com. I'm also at Reclaiming Motherhood, one word, at Instagram. Feel free to DM me and reach out. Until the next episode, I hope you take care, and I'll talk to you then.